We now have confirmation. A large volume of intruding magma, totaling a whopping 313 million cubic meters of material, was the source of a truly major earthquake storm in early 2025 that struck the famous volcanic island of Santorini in Greece. Peaking in intensity in early February 2025 and involving more than 30,000 earthquakes, it led to a state of emergency being declared and thousands of people to temporarily vacate the island. Several magnitude 5 range earthquakes even occurred in the storm, causing limited damage and some landslides. Yet, because of the unusualness of this earthquake storm, debates on whether it was tectonic or volcanic in origin went back and forth and were unresolved until now. As a scientific paper by Marius P. Iskin and others confirmed a volcanic origin, with a 13-kilometer-long magma dike forming and propagating to as little as 5 kilometers or 3.1 miles depth being noted. The episode of volcanic unrest began all the way back in July 2024 when a small batch of magma eventually totaling 4 million cubic meters of molten rock rose into Santorini's shallow magma chamber. This magma chamber was centered at 3.8 kilometers depth underneath the northern caldera segment of the overall volcano. This even led to increased surface degassing at the Nyakameni Island, but due to its absurdly small volume was way too small to have any chance of leading to a volcanic eruption on the surface, as you can see in this chart. Seismic activity further intensified on January 27th of 2025 when magma began moving underground at a depth of 18 kilometers east of the island. This magma continued to rise while also moving further and further to the northeast. This magma reached a mere 8 kilometers or 5 miles depth by February 1st, and by February 6th it was at a depth of 5 kilometers. Magma eventually migrated a full 13 kilometers or 8.1 miles horizontally, and then between February 10th and 11th, deep seismicity migrated 25 kilometers horizontally to the northeast. During this entire time, displacement of the ground and rising hydrothermal fluids lubricated regional faults in the local tectonic regime, making it easier for shallow crustal faults primarily on or near the seafloor to rupture and generate the observed earthquakes. The displacement of magma that fed this intrusion from a body of deeper crustal magma between the Santorini and Kolumbo volcanoes led to slight subsidence on the surface, with a portion of the Kolumbo volcano subsiding by as much as 32 centimeters or 12.6 inches. Then, the intrusion ended on February 24th, and seismic activity thereafter decreased. The state of emergency declaration was later rescinded and both residents and tourists returned to Santorini Island. In hindsight, during the entire observed sequence, there never was any danger of Santorini Island proper producing a volcanic eruption. However, while obviously no volcanic eruption occurred, there was for a time a chance that some volume of magma in the magma dike could have either 1. Intruded through a shallow crustal fault that passed through the shallow magma dike, or 2. Caused magma mixing at the Kolumbo volcano's magma chamber. Neither of those possibilities happened, and the entire time the chance of a submarine eruption was quite remote. Regardless, the existence of similarly oriented exposed magma dikes on Santorini's caldera walls suggests that similar events have likely occurred previously, although at what frequency is uncertain. Regardless, while both the Santorini and Kolumbo volcanoes in the long term have seemingly competed for magma from the same deep magma reservoir, the 2025 intrusion offers a potential solution to a previously unanswered question. And that question is a potential triggering mechanism for some of Kolumbo's geologically recent eruptions. You see, the magma dike intrusion had a presumably primitive composition with a low silica content. If this were to have hypothetically encountered the rhyolitic magmas underlying the Kolumbo volcano, the two could have mixed. And since this would lower the magma's viscosity, it would make it easier for existing molten rock to rise to the surface and potentially erupt. This could explain why Kolumbo's Plinian 1650 CE eruption occurred, although recent studies have found no evidence of such major magma mixing from that eruption's products. I hope that you found this video interesting. As a final note, I would like to thank everyone who has supported my work via Patreon or through being a YouTube channel member on YouTube.